Hi, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another weekly ramble. I'm your host, Scuba Steve, and I'm going to dive right into it. This week's episode is not going to be filled with news from this week. It's going to be filled with news, some big news that I didn't talk about. Well, I did mention very faintly, very lightly, in last week's episode of my weekly rambles. It was the KSI Logan Paul press conference, which, when I was recording my last weekly ramble, was going live. And I have to say, watching it from various perspectives, getting people's thoughts and views about it, Logan's views about it, JJ's views about it, Deji's, Tom Syndicate, Danny Filippo from Raka Raka, Keemstar as well, it's absolutely mind-boggling just how stupid the Paul brothers are. It's absolutely stupid, because you'd have Deji come on stage first. It was hosted by world heavyweight champion at boxing, Shannon Briggs, aka The Cannon, and he got Deji on stage first. Deji, the majority of the crowd were booing him. For the majority of the time, the crowd was booing him, and it was just putting a damper on this, on the entire event in general. Things didn't really peak until Jake came on stage, at which point Jake was being obnoxious and he was being bratty. He kept chanting Walmart because he tried to make Deji look like he just bought all of his gear from Walmart, where in fact, when you look at Jake Paul's suit, it looked like a carpet, it looked like a rug that you'd use for your lounge if you were a fancy, eccentric type guy. He was wearing heels, so he tried to make fun of Deji's height, saying he was 5'8", when actually Deji's about 5'9", 5'10". Here's the thing, called him comedy shorts boobs, bringing out a bra, body shaming. He actually called Rice Gum out on that, I believe it was last year, because Rice Gum was trying to say stuff about Alyssa. Jake had to make a video about Rice body shaming. Sorry, Jake, you are such a damn freaking hypocrite. Really? Body shaming. Throwing a bra at Deji. Body shaming. That's very hypocritical, Jake. Very hypocritical. I know you will not see this video because I'm so small and irrelevant of a YouTuber. No, you will not see this vid. I am 110% confident you will not see this video for me calling you out on your hypocrisy. You just chanting Walmart constantly and talking over Deji whenever Deji was trying to say something, trying to get the crowd's attention because it was his turn to speak. Because of the multiple times when it was his turn to speak. Very bratty of you, very childish of you. Really, you're 21 years old. I would expect better. Hell, a 13-year-old could probably act more appropriately and well-mannered than you. After Jake Paul came on, and after they tried to have a mini-roast and a mini-conference between Deji and Jake, Shannon brought on JJ, and oh my god, I loved JJ's entrance. He was all show, not all show, but he walked on stage with pride. I got the feeling like he owned the stage. I think that was what he was going for when he was coming onto the stage. He wanted to walk out there and make people look like he was owning it, and it was really well done. Then Logan came on. Logan came on very aggressive. He came immediately up to JJ's face, and it's like, really? Are you ready? Are you ready for this? And JJ's like, yeah, I'm born ready. You can tell Logan was just vamping the crowd. He was just reeling the crowd over from being JJ's side to his. The crowd, for the majority, were on the Paul side. And really, that's really poor. That is just poor showmanship. And I know that when there's a weigh-in, when the weigh-in happens over here in the UK, and possibly a second conference if not, then the crowd is definitely going to be more on Deji and JJ's side. I'm going to love that when that happens. That is going to be absolutely fantastic. Now, when Logan came up on stage, things started to get a bit more heated. You had JJ take miniature digs at Logan, being more specific towards the Suicide Forest scenario that Logan bore folly to in January. And it got to the point where they were exchanging gifts. JJ brought out Toy Story alien figurines because Logan wore a Toy Story alien hat in the video that he was in Akira Gohara Forest. He also brought out a book titled YouTube for Dummies. He brought out some clippers which got tossed into the crowd. Just as a message to Logan and Jake to like, yeah, get your hairline sorted. People keep going at me about my hairline. I'm doing something stylish with a bandana here. Why don't you go and sort your balding hairlines? Jesus. And then things get really heated because he gets a wig. And he wears it, and he tells the cameras, I want you to zoom in on me as I say this. I've made a severe and continuous lapse in my judgment. And as he's saying this, Logan is right here. Logan is immediately here, and it's quoting the opening sentences from his Suicide Forest apology video, and it snaps Logan. Logan has a temper tantrum because Logan then flips the wig off, goes to try and pull the bandana off, and it takes JJ a moment to process this, but he sorts the bandana and he charges at Logan. Logan makes the first move. Yes, as long he may deny it, he may say, "Oh, JJ threw a temper tantrum on stage." No, Logan, you made the first move. It was live streamed on your channel and his, and you had a live audience there, and you have multiple perspectives. You definitely made the first move. You threw the temper tantrum. You snapped Logan. Again, as well as I know that Jake will not see this video, I know that Logan will not see this video. I'm 110% confident, again, that Logan will not see this video. It's absolutely insane. The conference was cut short because when that happened and JJ tried to charge at Logan, he actually took a swipe at Logan and knocked his sunshades off. 15 members of Logan and Jake's team came up on stage to try and act as a shield between the Paul brothers and Deji and JJ. And there were so many people on stage that Shannon Briggs just basically went, "You know what, cut the feed, we're cutting this short." So the live stream ended, but there are videos from people like Danny Filippo, Tom Syndicate, where there were multiple perspectives taken. This stuff kept continuing. It's absolutely stupid. I'll link the conference in the description below. I will link Deji's response, like Deji's take on it. I will link Danny Filippo's from Raka Raka's view on it. I'll link Tom Syndicate's video about the conference as well. They will all be in the description below for you all to check out. I would really suggest you all do so, just to make sure you are seeing everything from every possible perspective you can. It was just absolutely mind-boggling to see that conference be such shambles. It's absolutely mind-boggling. Anyway, I don't know what I'm going to be doing in the next couple of weeks video-wise. I'm going to try and do something. You may notice some things may change, but it's only temporary. It's only going to be for a couple of weeks or so, and then I'll be back to my normal setup. So the video format may change over the next couple of weeks, and I'll explain more in the next ramble. But until then, leave a like, leave a comment, hit the subscribe button, make sure you're hitting the bell icon and getting all notifications on my uploads. But until next time, peace.